The story of Polybius is one of the most horrifying mysteries in video games. It started as one of the internet's earliest urban legends, and despite not having much evidence, the Polybius story lives on. It goes like this. In 1981, the United States government commissioned an addictive arcade game. Gameplay was similar to Tempest and incorporated puzzles and subliminal messages. It had horrible physical and mental effects on anyone who played it. It caused seizures, hallucinations, amnesia, night terrors. In extreme cases, the game caused suicide and even sudden death. The Polybius arcade cabinets were unmarked black boxes, and they only appeared in Portland, Oregon, and the surrounding suburbs. Men in black suits visited the arcades to download data the game generated on each of its players. Some say that the mental and physical toll the game took on its players was the government's method of finding highly qualified soldiers. Others say that Polybius was designed for mind control. It was published by a company called Sinneslertion, which in English very roughly translates to sensory deprivation. It created chaos and forever impacted the children who played it. Then, as quickly and mysteriously as Polybius entered the market, it vanished. For years, Polybius tales were relatively quiet. But that changed in 2006, when someone who identified himself as Stephen Roach posted on a coinop.org forum. He claimed that he set up the company that made Polybius, and that he and his fellow programmers were commissioned to do so by a Southern American company. He said they knew they were creating an addictive game, but panicked when Polybius gave an Oregon child an epileptic fit. He said they disbanded the company shortly after Polybius was pulled from the market. For some people, Stephen Roach's post was as validating as it was alarming. It corroborated a lot of what people thought they knew about Polybius. For them, his post was proof that Polybius existed, that it addicted and hurt its players, and that the game really was quietly pulled from the market. So that's the story, but is any of it actually true? Let's start with the public record, and let's just assume that Polybius really existed and that it did hurt its players. Mainstream news sources would have definitely covered such a controversial game. In the early 80s, arcades were considered pretty seedy establishments. Such a scandalous story would have made national news. On top of that, there were publications that focused solely on the gaming industry. But when Polybius supposedly hit the market in the early 80s, it was never mentioned. In fact, the earliest references to Polybius only appeared several years after the game was allegedly released, and were written in the context of it being a mysterious urban legend. But just because it didn't appear in the media doesn't mean that Polybius never existed. What about those kids who got sick in arcades? And what about the men in black suits? This was all pretty intriguing to journalist Kat Despira. She grew up in Portland. She moved there when she was a young teen, and she actually hung out at the arcade where Polybius supposedly tormented its players. She spent a good portion of her adolescence there, and remembers that Portland was a test market for new video games. She says that sometimes unmarked cabinets would appear in local arcades. They'd be labeled simply New Game, or they'd have a name, but that name could change by the time it was officially released. Despite spending a lot of time in Portland area arcades, Kat didn't hear about the Polybius story until she was an adult. But instead of writing Polybius off as an odd urban legend, Kat looked into it. In fact, she spent months researching the story. And what she and other researchers have found is that there are kernels of truth to the Polybius story. One bit of truth is that kids got sick at arcades. Around the time that Polybius was allegedly released, 12-year-old Brian Morrow developed an upset stomach while playing a video game. It made the news. Brian had been playing for 28 hours straight. He was going for a record, but a stomach ache brought on by too many Coca-Colas took him out of the running. Here's the thing though, he was playing Asteroids, not Polybius. Later, at the same arcade and on the same day, a 14-year-old named Michael Lopez developed his first migraine. But he was playing Tempest. A year later in Illinois, an 18-year-old named Peter Burkowski died from a heart attack while playing Berserk. So people have gotten sick while playing video games. And some have even died playing video games. It's true that flashing lights in the right pattern can cause seizures. Some people probably have gotten seizures while playing video games, but none of these incidents have been traced back to Polybius. In all likelihood, they just helped build the rumors about Polybius and make the story seem more credible. But what about the men in black suits who came to download data from the Polybius machines? Well, there's a kernel of truth there too. In an interview with Eurogamer, Todd Luoto, who was working on a documentary about Polybius, explained that the FBI did hang around Portland arcades. But that's because back in the early 80s, arcades didn't exactly have a family-friendly reputation. Arcades were sometimes seen as havens for gambling or drug abuse. In early December of 1981, right around the time that Polybius was on the market, and not long after the Portland boys got sick playing Asteroids and Tempest, the FBI concluded a year-long investigation into a Portland-area arcade owner who was accused of rigging his arcade cabinets for gambling. Then, in 1982, after a seven-month undercover sting operation, federal agents arrested 25 suspects in Games People Play Arcade in Seattle, Washington, on charges of racketeering. And then there's Stephen Roach, the man who claimed to help create Polybius. While some believe him, his story seems sketchy at best. In his long, rambling post, he makes several grammatical errors. He even misspells the name of the company he claimed to help set up. A lot of people have raised doubts about the name of the company, Sinneslurchen, which in English translates to sensory deprivation, but apparently is an awkward word combination that a fluent German speaker probably wouldn't use. Kat DeSpira, one of the journalists who investigated this issue, believes she tracked down the Stephen Roach who wrote the post. Her conclusions are unsettling. In her article, she writes that he and his wife ran horrific behavioral modification schools for children, where the kids were subjected to physical and sexual abuse. It's a disturbing story, but it's hard to know whether the person who wrote the coin-op post was even really named Stephen Roach, let alone whether he was the same Stephen Roach that Kat discovered. Either way, the Stephen Roach post adds to the Polybius mystery, a mystery with some kernels of truth, but not much evidence to back it up. Whether you think Polybius is real or not, we can probably all agree that the story isn't going to die out anytime soon. It's one of gaming's biggest urban legends. It was a joke on The Simpsons. And last month, a Polybius game was even added to the PlayStation Store. Personally, I don't believe Polybius was ever a real game, but it does make for a good story. That's all for this episode of The Gaming Historian. Thanks for watching.
Funding for Gaming Historian is provided in part by supporters on Patreon. Thank you.